The purpose of this video session is to tell you what are the legal characters or legal alphabets or legal symbols from the keyboard you can use in your C program. The best way to understand a little bit about this characters or character set which can be used in your C programming language is to draw a comparison or an analogy with the learning the English language. So if you had to learn the English language, or if you had to learn even Hindi, your teachers would have taught you the alphabets A, B, C, K, K, G initially. After you learned the alphabets, then you would have learned to form words. After you have learned to form words, you would create sentences following the rules of grammar and logic or semantics. And then you would convey your thoughts through writing a number of paragraphs or essays. Similarly, if you had to write a program or learn a programming language, you have to first understand what are the legal characters permitted in that particular language. Characters, you mean what are the keys from the keyboard permitted. So using this character set, you can define constants, create variables, create expressions as I told you, and keywords. Keywords are words provided by the language which have specific meaning. For example, the keyword int means that I am going to declare variables of the integer type. Float means I am going to declare variables of the floating type. So those are examples of keyword int and float. We'll come across more keywords as we progress in our C journey. So using the character set, using all these, we will create a series of instructions. These instructions help us develop programs. Now let us try to understand what are the valid character set in C programming language. So the valid character set of C programming language consists of alphabets. I'll show you what are the alphabets which are valid, which digits are valid. Then you can use any number of blank spaces, tabs or enter key without any problem. And then some special characters. These all form the character set of the C programming language. Now, the first character set which is valid is the alphabets. So alphabets consists of uppercase letters A to Z and lowercase letters A to Z. Digits consist of numbers starting from 0 to 9. Using their combination, you can create different numbers. So your program will consist of alphabets and digits. This is followed by some special characters. There are a number of special characters which are permitted in C programming language. So on your left and right side, you can take a look at the different special characters. It is not necessary and also impossible to tell you the meaning and working of each particular character at this particular time. As we progress in our journey of learning data types, operators, functions, pointers, and so on, all of these particular special characters are going to be used. For example, this stands for special character stands for addition. Okay. This character stands for the minus sign. This stands for the assignment or double assignment it is, then it is equality. This stands for beginning and end of a block. This stands for the end of an instruction or end of a statement. So all these special characters along with alphabets, digits, and these special characters will be present in your C program. If you use any special character other than these, you are going to get an error by the compiler. Now, so far we have used the backslash n. If you remember, what we have done is when we do the backslash n, in order to give you an understanding of what the backslash n means, let me take a simple example. So what I mean with the backslash n is, suppose, let's say this is your screen. Here you are printing a message on this particular line. After printing a message, your cursor, the equal to sign, comes and stops here. When the C printf or any statement encounters the backslash n, the cursor is brought to the beginning of the next line. So the equal to will come on the next line. So backslash n is an example of an invisible character which brings your cursor on the next line. Suppose in your printf, if you type backslash a, you'll get a single beep sound. Suppose you want to print double quote on the output screen. Double quote can be printed by backslash double quote. Because there is already double quote within the printf, it will confuse. To remove the confusion, we have a backslash in front of a double quote to print a double quote. Same with single quote. Suppose you want to print a backslash, you will use two backslashes to print one backslashes. So these all characters, you can take a look at the lecture notes in the description section. These are known as backslash character constants. In the technical terminology, they are also called as execution character set. All of these characters here are non-printable. That means if you type backslash A or if you print backslash A, you cannot see it on the screen, but you will get a beeping sound. That's why they are known as unprintable characters or execution character set. These unprintable characters are used to perform very specific functions like doing an automatic backspace, moving the cursor to a new line, creating a beep or ringing a bell. Now you need to understand, although it is showing up as two characters, backslash and double quote, the backslash is just used to indicate that it is not the double quote, but it is a backslash double quote. So each of these character constants represents one constant. Although they are shown as two characters, they actually represent one single character. Therefore, these character combinations are also known as escape sequence. Why are they called escape sequence? Because you are not simply using the double quote, you are using the backslash. Using the backslash, you are removing the special meaning of double quote, which the C printf statement normally assumes. And you say you are interested to print the double quote, you are not interested to enclose something in the double quote. So here if you want to print question mark, you will do backslash question mark. That means the special meaning the C compiler assumes with a question mark is ignored. Same with double backslash. If you put only one backslash, you will get an error. Double backslash means the special meaning associated with a single backslash is removed. Similarly, backslash n. Simple n will do nothing for you. It will print the value n. Backslash n means take the cursor to the next line. So I hope I have been able to give you an idea about the character set of C. In some of the videos ahead, I'll be talking about what are keywords and something called as tokens also. But for now, this should be good enough to start doing programming in your labs.